is Renegade Biker 24. Let's see, yeah, it says low ambient temperature. And, okay. So that low ambient temperature is 35 degrees. I have 8,500 miles on my bad boy. And, yeah, that's what I have. Amazing, huh? Okay. All right, y'all. I am heading home, but the first thing I gotta do before I head home is go pay the criminals. At least that's what I call them. And call them that because they keep ripping me off every month. And that's the mobile home lot rent people. And $393 this month compared to last month, which was about $380. So it's gone up about $10 thanks to the water, which I end up having to let my faucets drip so they don't freeze. But anyway, so I am off to pay these criminals, because if I don't, then they charge me $35 a late fee, and then it's like $2.50 after that if I don't pay them by the 6th. So basically, they're like a, what's the word I'm looking for? Oh, yeah, mafia. They're like mafia. But, anyway, so, it's amazing that I've been there about 14 years, and they just don't seem to realize that, the crap that they do is illegal in this state. But there's another thing, and I'm working on that, and that's this stupid Landlord-Tenant Act that they've got, and which is actually more geared toward the landlord than it is the tenant. And so the landlord can screw over the tenant in any way possible. And then they go, well, it's all because of this, it's all because of that. You know, I've heard so many freaking lies that it's not even funny. I've heard so many lies. Lies ranging from it's close to a golf course to that's the reason why, because it's close to a golf course, and I don't pay any green fees. Yet it's not even on the golf course. It's not like some places that I've been when I deliver pizza, which is, there's a place that's called Pinnacle Hills. And the promenade, which that right there, it's on Promenade Boulevard, or off of Promenade Boulevard, but that right there, I could see why. I mean, there's a community, and it's got a whole bunch of houses, and it's on a golf course, and it's like it's a pretty much golf course, probably like a 9-hole golf course, and it's on a golf course, and so you have a whole bunch of nice houses. We're talking nice houses. I've been in the one actually in Shadow Valley, which is another place that's real nice, but I bet the rent is probably higher than what I'm paying. And so that's what it's like. Now, if you all have seen my Shadow Valley videos, check them out. If you can't find them, they're on a playlist, and I think there's under Suburban. It's under a Suburban playlist. So I think it's Suburban Visits, something like that. You'll see it. Anyway, those are nice houses. Now, I could see the reason for the rent to be high. I don't see why a mobile home lot rent has to be as high, and they say that they are also competing with other mobile homes in the area. Other mobile homes in the area are $250 a month for lot rent, plus maybe $100 and something for a security deposit. Now, that's just a one-time security deposit, but it's $250 a month compared to these jokers that are $341. And yet these people don't do anything. They don't fix anything on my property. And they just pretty much say, well, we're just gonna not do anything. They have yet to do anything on my property that warrants an increase in lot rent. Now, the reason I'm slowing down here, and even though it's 35, I'm gonna go probably 30. It's 35 here. The reason is because the Johnson cops are looking for a reason. And the Johnson cops in this part, they hide out. They have black cruiser, black and silver cruiser, and if I ever run into one, hopefully videotape it. But these people will, or the cops here will give you a ticket if you're 1 mile over. Now, let's see, this is 30 miles an hour, so I'm going to kick it on down to about 28, 29. So, even, let's see, you're 28. These cops will give you a ticket if you're 1 mile over the speed limit. They really need the revenue. So, this is what it's all about here. That's why I'm going below the speed limit. But, anyway, and what I usually do on my envelope is I give the time that I dropped it off. That way they can't say anything. They can't say that I didn't get it to them on time, stuff like that. Now, here's the place where I drop off the lot rent, because these dumb idiots haven't wanted to put a drop box over at Northern Hills, even though they could have had it there, but they refused to do that because they're a bunch of idiots anyway. But anyway, so now I'm going to put the date, or the time actually, so they know that I, I was here. These people have yet to do anything that would warrant any sort of lot rent. Let's see, please fix my sidewalk. That is correct. And let's see here, my water main outlet needs sod around it. And please destroy concrete slab next to my home on the hill facing the other driveway. See that this is done immediately. I will be watching to see if you snowplow the road, the F Street, when weather turns icy and snowy. Okay, so these people better start doing their job. Otherwise, I will consult HUD. consult every, and I will consult every law enforcement, and also I will consult every housing authority here in this state, and I will contact my congressman, and I am serious about this. This is ridiculous, y'all. Oh, crap. Damn it. Okay. Now, this is the Oak Glen mobile home community. These are the dumb idiots that decide when the lot rent is going to be increased. Now, if they increase it more, I've already contacted the Attorney General, and I am going to contact every, and I do mean every, housing authority here in the state. And you know what? I really don't care if they watch this video. I hope they do watch it, because I'm tired of it. I am tired of being bullied. I am tired of being harassed. And this crap has got to stop. But anyway, just wanted to show you that. Now, this is the, this is what I call the heart attack hill, because if you take a bicycle up this thing, yeah, you'll do okay from this point back, but going up it is even more of a challenge. As you can see, it's not, it doesn't look that big of a challenge here, but for a bicycle, it is a big challenge. So, and right in this area is where they have pretty much done a lot of renovating here. As you can see, that street never was here before, and this has only been here like, oh, I'd say a couple months now. But off the side there, you don't see anything, but that used to be a big warehouse. That there's no warehouse there anymore, and it's where the train tracks kind of go around. But anyway, so this is Johnson Road, and like I said, right here in Johnson is a place where you don't want to speed. Cops do hang out here, and they will give you a ticket. So anyway, and right up here, as you can see, that is the Tyson Feed Mill. And the Tyson feed trucks go on Shady Grove Road almost on a constant basis. And right here is where they kind of improved the street a little bit. You can see how it just kind of goes down, and you can see when it rains, it just kind of goes off here, and then it kind of builds up right next to the train track. Then there's like a big old alleyway there. Man, it is foggy. Okay. So anyway, and this is Razorback Farms. I'm not really sure what this is, because this has been here for a long time. It's been here ever since I've moved here. So, this is the mobile home lot rent people. I don't know if you can see that up ahead, but there's a big old half moon. I don't know if you guys can see that. But, yeah, that's just right up there. You know what? I think I'm going to go and check that out, so you guys can see that, and I can videotape it. And you can see it's a crescent moon. I mean, that's really cool, isn't it? See if I can get a little farther. I'll just turn around up here, because this is a dead end street. But I just wanted you guys to see this, guys and gals. But, see if I can't try to find a different view of it. There we go. And chase the moon down. Okay. You all can see that. Anyway, well, I guess that's it. But you all get to see some of the other Christmas lights from the neighbors. That they put up. As you can see, some have them up, some don't. But anyway, wanted you all to see that. And just start heading back. Started heading back home, but I wanted you guys to see what the neighborhood that I live in. So, anyway, it's 1:06 in the morning. All right, y'all. Well, I'm gonna take you on a little tour. It isn't the usual route I usually take. But anyway, just wanted you all to see that. This is Shady Grove Road. Anyway, y'all, I'm almost home, so what I will do is I will cut this log here just as soon as I turn into my driveway, and I'll call it a night. But anyway, anyway, this is Renegade Biker 24, and I am on my CTX 1300 Deluxe, and I will talk to you all later, and I'll see you in the next vlog.